Hello everyone, I am Deepak from Udaan Class 10 Rapid Revision Class. Now I am going to discuss social science topic Opposition to British Rule in Karnataka. It is the history 4th chapter. So let us begin our discussion. See, the entire discussion is based on the two parts. In first part we'll discuss about the most expected 2, 3, 4 mark questions, and in second part we'll discuss most likely 1 mark questions and fill in the blanks. Okay, so let us begin with the part 1. In part 1, as I've already told, we'll discuss about the most expected 2, 3, 4 marks questions. So when it comes to opposition to the British rule in Karnataka, you should remember the Hyder Ali. Okay, so how did Hyder Ali come to power? Hyder Ali joined Mysore army as an ordinary soldier. See here, Hyder Ali, he joined Mysore army as an ordinary soldier, but he was known for his shrewd political moves, very bold political moves. He was closely observing the political developments of Mysore. Yes, so what all political developments is going within the territory of Mysore is observed by Hyder Ali, and he came into prominence during the siege of Devanahalli. When Devanahalli got seized, Hyder Ali became the most prominent person there, and the military action against Nizam of Arcot. So at that time, the military action is undertaken by the Hyder Ali, and Hyder Ali won hearts of soldiers. So he got name and fame during this situation, and he became famous as Nawab Hyder Ali in short time. So in very short time, he gained name and fame. He was known for his innovations in arms usage. So even he used different types of arms and weapons. So he even known for his innovations also. With his swift actions, he weakened the power of Dalwai and sidelined the King Krishna Raja Wadeyar and established control over the administration. So with this, he became the most administrative person of the kingdom of Mysore. Then first Anglo-Mysore war. What are the reasons for first Anglo-Mysore war? See, the first Anglo-Mysore war is started in current era 1767, that is 1767, and it ended in current era CE 1769. So it ran for 2 years. During this, the province gained by the Hyder Ali in the south was not tolerated by the British. So due to the political developments and due to the major achievements of Hyder Ali, the entire south region was under the control of Hyder Ali. So and this was not tolerated by the British. Not only British, even Marathas and even the Nizam of Hyderabad. So the prominence gained by the Hyder Ali in the south was not tolerated by the British, Marathas and the Nizam of Hyderabad. Hence, the British started devising cunning plans. So they started using very cunning plans to defeat Hyder Ali, whom they saw an impedance for the expansionist ideas. So impedance means resistance. So they thought that Hyder Ali will not allow British to rule in India, entire India. So they wanted to defeat Hyder Ali. Though Hyder Ali suffered a lot due to Maratha aggression, even Marathas were very unhappy with the Hyder Ali. So even Hyder Ali was getting suffered from Marathas. He made attempts to have Marathas and Nizam of Hyderabad on his side with little success. So even though he tried and many attempts to make Marathas and Nizam of Hyderabad on his sides with little success. Then we'll move on to the second Anglo-Mysore war. It has taken place between 1782 1784, nearly for 4 years. What are the reasons for second Anglo-Mysore war? See, the political situation in Travancore and तंजावुर वॉज द मेन रीजन बिहाइंड दिस वॉर. सो वॉट इज द मेन रीजन बिहाइंड सेकेंड एंग्लो मैसूर वॉर? द मेन रीजन वॉज द पॉलिटिकल सिचुएशन दैट अरोज इन ट्रावणकोर एंड तंजावुर. सी द मराठा ट्रीटी हैड पुट द पॉलिटिकल डेवलपमेंट्स इन साउथ इंडिया ऑन अ टेम्पररी होल्ड. दिस मराठा मद्रास ट्रीटी, सॉरी द मद्रास ट्रीटी विच हैज़ टेकन प्लेस दैट हैज़ मेड द पॉलिटिकल डेवलपमेंट्स इन साउथ इंडिया ऑन अ वेरी टेम्पररी होल्ड. द ब्रिटिश अटेम्प्टेड टू ब्रेक दिस मद्रास ट्रीटी. वेन माधवराव अटैक्ड श्रीरंगनापटना विथ मराठा आर्मी, हैदर अली एक्सपेक्टेड द ब्रिटिश सपोर्ट हिम एज मद्रास ट्रीटी. सी इन मद्रास ट्रीटी द ब्रिटिश सेड दैट और द ब्रिटिश डिक्लेयर दैट दे विल हेल्प हैदर अली इन डिफिकल्ट सिचुएशंस लाइक इन वॉर और समथिंग. बट वेन माधवराव अटैक श्रीरंगनापटना विथ हिज मराठा आर्मी, हैदर अली एक्सपेक्टेड, सो ही वॉज एक्सपेक्टिंग द ब्रिटिश पीपल टू कम एंड सपोर्ट हिम एज पर द मद्रास ट्रीटी. बट द ब्रिटिश रिजेक्टेड द रिक्वेस्ट ऑफ हैदर अली. द ब्रिटिश डिड नॉट सपोर्ट द हैदर अली एंड वेंट अगेंस्ट मद्रास ट्रीटी. सो दे ब्रोक दिस मद्रास ट्रीटी विच दे हैव साइंड विद द हैदर अली. माहे द फ्रेंच कॉलोनी वॉज अंडर द होल्ड ऑफ हैदर अली. सो माहे इज अ कॉलोनी विच इज अ फ्रेंच कॉलोनी विच वॉज अंडर द कंट्रोल ऑफ हैदर अली. द ब्रिटिश अटैक्ड माहे. सो वॉट डिज द ब्रिटिश पीपल डू इज विच वॉज अ माहे विच वॉज अ फ्रेंच कॉलोनी इच इज अटैक्ड बाय द ब्रिटिश एंड दे कैप्चर्ड इट. सो दिस इज द मेन रीजन वॉट वी सी बिहाइंड द सेकेंड एंग्लो मैसूर वॉर. देन वॉट आर द इफेक्ट्स ऑफ दिस सेकेंड एंग्लो मैसूर वॉर? टिप्पू सुल्तान थॉट ऑफ ऑल दिस डेवलपमेंट्स एंड ही डिसाइडेड टू प्रोटेक्ट मंगलूरू एंड कोस्टल रीजन्स. सो ही डिफीटेड द ब्रिटिश. सो टिप्पू सुल्तान कम्स इन टू प्लेस हियर. सो वेन ही गॉट टू नो ऑल दिस डेवलपमेंट्स आउट दिस माहे हैज़ बीन कैप्चर्ड बाय द ब्रिटिश, देन टिप्पू सुल्तान ही गॉट टू नो ऑल दिस डेवलपमेंट्स एंड ही डिसाइडेड टू प्रोटेक्ट द मंगलूरु एंड ऑल द कोस्टल रीजन्स विच आर सराउंडिंग द मंगलूर रीजन एंड ही डिफीटेड द ब्रिटिश. सो ही वॉज सक्सेसफुल इन डिफीटिंग द ब्रिटिश इन सेकेंड एंग्लो मैसूर वॉर. एंड द सेकेंड एंग्लो मैसूर वॉर एंडेड विद द ट्रीटी ऑफ मंगलूरु बिकॉज वेर इन द टिप्पू सुल्तान सेफ गार्डेड द रीजन ऑफ मंगलूरु. देन द थर्ड एंग्लो मैसूर वॉर विच हैज़ टेकन प्लेस बिटवीन 1790 टू 1792, नियरली फॉर 2 years अगेन. What are the reasons for Third Anglo-Mysore War? The politics of Travancore was the main reason for this war. So here, the politics what has taken place in Travancore, that is the main reason for the Third Anglo-Mysore War. The king of the Travancore built a fort in Kochi. See, the king of Travancore, he built a fort in Kochi with the help of British and captured Ayakota and Kanganur forts from the Dutch. So what did happen here is the king of Travancore built a fort in Kochi with the help of British and they captured Ayakota and Kanganur fort from the Dutch. So all these were the clear breach of the Mangaluru Treaty. So according to Mangaluru Treaty, they should not capture the Dutch or the any other territories, but there is a clear breach or the breaking the conditions of the Mangaluru Treaty can be seen in the Third Anglo-Mysore War. So nearly again 1789 to 92, then it was fought between Tipu Sultan and the British, that is Lord Cornwallis, and it ended with the Treaty of Srirangapatna. So this is a small highlight which we have shown in this Third Anglo-Mysore War. Now what were the conditions of this Treaty of Srirangapatna which ended the Third Anglo-Mysore War? See, Tipu was forced to part with half of his kingdom. That means he was forced to give half of his kingdom. Part means to break or to give half of his kingdom to the British and was forced to pay 3 crore rupees as a war damage fee. So he has paid a fees that we did mention here, it has war damage fees of how much? It is 3 crore rupees. And not only this, he had to pledge. Pledge means he had given two of his children as a guarantee against the payment. That means if he is unable to pay the money, his children had to be taken. So like Giri, what do you tell? They had given, Tipu Sultan has given two children for mortgage, you can say. Unless and until he pays the money, the two children will be with the British, along with the British, as an hostages. He was forced to release the prisoners of war. The Tipu was forced to release all the prisoners of war against the British, and the British withdrew the combined army from the Srirangapatna. So the British had taken withdrawn their combined army from the Srirangapatna. So the next one is Fourth Anglo-Mysore War. Okay, so that is. Then what are the reasons for the Fourth Anglo-Mysore War? Tipu Sultan took the defeat in Third Anglo-Mysore War very personally. See, in Third Anglo-Mysore War, Tipu lost two of his children, means he had given as hostages. Then half of his kingdom had been given to the British. So now Tipu, this all he has taken personally. The Third Anglo-Mysore War defeat he has taken personally. He paid all the dues and got released his children. So all the money, nearly he had paid 3 crore rupees. So he paid all that dues and he got released his children. He also gave away the territory to the British and its allies as agreed. So whatever the conditions they have signed, so all that he has fulfilled. He claimed his right over Malabar region. So he told that Malabar is his region, so I will take the right over there under the British occupation. But British refused this argument. So British told that will not give you Malabar region. So Tipu sent an ambassador to France to seek the alliance of the French. So Tipu has taken the help of French here. Then the Fourth Anglo-Mysore strengthened the position of British in Mysore. How? We'll just discuss. See, with the death of Tipu Sultan, the British were very happy as if the whole India came under their rule, because Tipu was very powerful. And after his death, the British were very happy as they thought that the whole India came under their rule. Most of the territories which were under the Tipu's rule was shared among the British. So the British has undertaken all those territories which were under the control of Tipu. Not only British, even it is shared by the Marathas and the Nizam of Hyderabad or Hyderabad Nizams. A small territory was handed over to the royal representative of Mysore Vadeyars. This region came to be known as Mysore Princely State. Now we'll just discuss on Dondia Wagh. Okay, so explain the method of resisting the British power by Dondia Wagh. How did the people or how did the Dondia Wagh incident, they were very power, what it is, they were very create they, how they have created the resistive power, British power in Dondia Wagh. So what that all will be discussed here. See, Dondia was born in Maratha family of Channagiri. He was called as a Wagh means tiger due to his bravery. He started his career as a cavalry soldier in Hyder Ali's army and grew to the position of military general. He built his own private army and fought along with Tipu Sultan. So he fought along with Tipu. Due to the differences with Tipu, he was imprisoned. The British released him from the prison after the Fourth Anglo-Mysore War. So after Fourth Anglo-Mysore War, wherein the Tipu died, the British released Dondia Wagh. He built a small army. So Dondia Wagh built a small army and started his operations. He organized the army with the unhappy soldiers of Tipu's army and the feudatory rulers who had lost powers. So he captured Bidnuru and Shimoga forts and made unsuccessful attempts to capture Chitradurga fort. So now we just discuss on the Sangoli Rayanna. So explain the methods adopted by the Rayanna to fight the British. Rayanna was a brave soldier. He fought for independence of Kitturu. Okay, like Kitturu Rani Chennamma, along with Kitturu Rani Chennamma, Sangoli Rayanna, he fought for the independence of Kittur, and he felt it was his duty to liberate means to make his motherland independent. He fought with Rani Chennamma and was imprisoned along with her. He developed a sense of nationalism and went on organizing an army. So he developed a sense of nationalism in the sense he thought that it is his motherland and I should protect my motherland to get it independent, and he went on organizing the army against the British. He went on organizing secret meetings, so without British knowing what's their plans. So he went on organizing secret meetings at sensitive geographical locations, means at very hidden places they started conducting the meetings. He aimed at looting the treasury. So what did this Rayanna do? Rayanna aimed at looting the treasury and the talukas or taluk office of the British. He had an army of 500 men. So in a very short time he built an army of 500 men, and he aimed at looting the treasury and the taluka offices of British. He became furious with the villagers who were assisting the British army. So he became very angry with the villagers who were supporting the British army. The British devised a cunning strategy to capture Rayanna. So the British started using cunning strategies anyhow they want to capture the Rayanna. So they started cunning strategies. Rayanna was cunningly captured. Cunningly means unknowingly, without his knowledge. He got betrayed. So Rayanna was cunningly captured and was brought down to Dharwad region. He was declared as an offender and he was hanged till death. Now we'll study about the contribution of Putta Basappa of Kodagu in freedom struggle. See, Putta Basappa, again will commonly it is known as Amarasulya movement also, which has taken place roughly around 1837. So Putta Basappa organized the rebels and calmed down the people. So here we are talking about the contribution of Putta Basappa of Kodagu region, okay, in freedom struggle, how you fought against British. See here, all what we have learned, what you are studying are just a small incident which has taken, but we can see even the Karnataka, the people of Karnataka have shown nationalistic feelings towards the independence, liberation of our love towards their motherland, to protect our land, and how they have protested against the British is shown here. So how did this Putta Basappa of Kodagu, he contributed in freedom struggle? It's a small part, but it has major impact at that time. See, Putta Basappa organized the rebels. Rebels means those people who are against the British here. Putta Basappa organized the rebels and calmed down the people. He declared that tax on tobacco and salt will be withdrawn if the rebel government assumes power. The rich farmers, landowners, and local chieftains were assured of this move. The capture of the government office in Ballari was the first move in this rebellion. Putta Basappa killed an amaldar who was known for his brutality, further increased the popularity of Putta Basappa. See, Putta Basappa, after killing Amaldar, so his popularity got increased, and this incident gained more support for the rebellion, and rebellion became more famous. Now, Surpura Nayakas. The British government, so here we'll discuss on the Surpura rebellion in brief. How did this Surpura rebellion takes place against the British again? See, the British government was absorbing the various development of Surpura, so they got to know how Surpura people are getting enraged, furious, and it came to the notice of the government that the representatives of Nana Sahiba were present in the Surpuras. So the British came to know that the Nana Sahib's representatives were present in Surpura. This made the British suspicious, doubtful of King's intention, and the British appointed an officer named Campbell to report on various activities of the king. So the British they appointed their officer there. His name was Campbell, to report the various activities of the king. The officer submitted a report to the resident of Hyderabad that king is involved in misadministration. Misadministration means something he is doing, some illegal activities there. So the British army captured the Surpura. Now let us discuss on the achievements of Kittur Rani Chennamma. See, after the death of Shivalinga Rudra Sarja, Chennamma adopted a boy named Shivalingappa and started ruling Kitturu as a queen regent. Thackeray sent a report to the governor of Bombay and attempted to take over the Kittur kingdom under the doctrine of lapse policy. So according to doctrine of lapse policy, adopted children cannot be come to throne. That means they are not allowed to become king. So that was the policy that is known as doctrine of lapse. But when Kittur Rani Chennamma, she adopted Shivalingappa after the death of Shivalinga Rudra Sarja, Thackeray sent a report to the governor of Bombay and attempted to take over the Kitturi kingdom under the doctrine of lapse policy. He attempted to take over the treasury and fort under his control. So Thackeray wanted to take the treasury and the fort under his control. The British attacked Kittur again under the leadership of Colonel Deak. The army fought the battle bravely. Chennamma attempted to flee from the battle, for sure she wanted to escape from the battlefield, but she was captured by the British army. Chennamma and others were imprisoned at Bailongala fort. Queen Chennamma passed away in the prison. She has remained the idol person till today. Now explain the rebellion of Bedas of Halagali. How did these Bedas of Halagali, they fought against the British? See, Bedas means hunters. Okay, see, Halagali is a small village of Mudol Taluk of Belgaum district. In 1857, when during the first war of Indian independence, the British banned the usage of weapons because these Bedas hunters, they had a tradition to keep the weapons with them. As the Bedas, who always kept guns as a part of customs, and they were good hunters, they rebelled against the British when they were asked to surrender their firearms. When British asked them to surrender their weapons or the firearms, they became very furious, very angry, and they rebelled against them. The Bedas of Manturu, Bodani, Algundi, and others joined the Halagali Bedas. Halagali, it is written, but it is pronounced as Halagali Bedas. The British army entered Halagali village to suppress the rebellion. They suppressed the Bedas in an inhuman way. All the rebels were hanged to till death. Next, explain the revolt of Veerappa of Koppal. See, Veerappa, who is a Jamindar, he rebelled against the British and occupied the fort of Koppal and other forts in the vicinity. Many farmers and Jamindars supported after realizing his motives. The British contacted the Nizam and their army to defeat Veerappa. Veerappa, who had lesser soldiers, died fighting the army of the British. The British captured back the fort of Koppal. Though this rebellion was very short-lived one, Veerappa proved himself to be a good warrior. Now let us discuss fastly regarding the most likely one mark questions and FIBs. Okay, so fill in the blanks. The first Anglo-Mysore War took place between Hyder Ali and the British in 1767. The second Anglo-Mysore War ended with Mangaluru Treaty. Kitturu Chennamma adopted a boy named Shivalingappa. Rayanna of Kittur state belonged to Sangoli village. Surpura is in the present district of Yadgir. The Bedas of Halagali village of Belagam district rebelled against the British. The Amarasulla rebellion was basically a farmers' rebellion. By which treaty first Anglo-Mysore War came to an end? The first Anglo-Mysore War came to an end by Madras Treaty. Which treaty ended the second Anglo-Mysore War? The Treaty of Mangaluru ended the second Anglo-Mysore War. What is the main reason for the second Anglo-Mysore War? The political situation in Travancore and Tanjore was the main reason behind the second Anglo-Mysore War. What is the main reason for the third Anglo-Mysore War? The politics of Travancore was the main reason for the third Anglo-Mysore War. Why Dondia is called Wog? It was called as Wog the Tiger due to its bravery. Where is Kittur? Kittur lies between Dharwad and Belagam. Who is Shivalinga Rudra Sarja? Shivalinga Rudra Sarja is a son of Malla Sarja and Chennamma. Who is adopted son of Kittur Rani Chennamma? The adopted son of Kittur Rani Chennamma is Shivalingappa. Where was Chennamma imprisoned? Chennamma was imprisoned at Bailongala Fort. Who remained an ideal person till today? Chennamma remained an ideal person till today. Who raised a rebellion against the British in Surpura? Venkatappa Nayaka raised a rebellion against the British in Surpura. So he is commonly called as Surpura Venkatappa Nayaka. Who was known for his innovation in arms usage? Hyder Ali was known because he fought against the British very bravely. How did Hyder Ali die? Hyder Ali died due to the illness during the war. Whose ballads have kept the life and bravery alive till today? Many ballads have kept the life and bravery of Rayanna alive till today. So Rayanna is the answer here. Why did Bedas of Alagari rebel against the British? They rebelled against the British when they were asked to surrender their firearms. So with this, we'll just finish this topic. Thank you so much for listening. If you are having any doubt, suggestions, feedback, please comment below. And please don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. Thank you so much.